In the last few videos, we talked about how desperately the semiconductor industry needs UV to cut down the cost associated with each of the lithography and patterning steps. And we also talked about how challenging this is. There are a lot of challenges in the UV source, in the optics, and so on. So what I want to talk about in this video is what if UV lithography doesn't happen? So what is our plan B? So are there a next set of next generation of lithography techniques that we are looking at? So this chart over here describes the ITRS roadmap for lithography from the year 2011. What does it? It lists out the different lithography options at each technology node. So we noticed that at 45 and 32, we basically got around by using 119.3 immersion lithography. Then we switched to double patterning. Going forward, it says you need UV. So UV is a constant and all going forward. But what if it doesn't happen? So it lists out the multiple options over here. So I want to describe in these in this video what these other options are. And you can see that at 11 nanometer, it even lists out innovation. And you really know that you are in big trouble if your roadmap says innovation. So what are the other techniques available to us that we can bank on if UV doesn't happen? So what I want to describe in this video are three of these techniques. So the first thing I want to talk to you about is listed over here, which is imprint or nano imprint lithography. The second technique that I want to describe to you is called DSA, which stands for directed self-assembly. And I'll talk to you what it means. Finally, the last technique I want to talk to you about is what is noted over here as ML2 or massless lithography, or we can also say e-beam lithography. So let's start with the nano imprint first. So what nano imprint entails is described in very nicely in this chart. So what it says is you spray your wafer. So you take your wafer and spray it with your resist, and you come on from the top using this stencil or using this template, which has your feature already patterned into it, and you press this template on top of your resist, which is in liquid phase. So this you pattern your whatever feature you want on this liquid resist, and then you do a UV cure, and so that pattern is baked into your resist, and then you remove this template, and the pattern is essentially embossed into your resist. So this is, I'm taking this image from this company called Molecular Imprint. So it was a company based, it's a company based out in Austin, started out from UT Austin, which developed this technique and is now trying to commercialize it. So we're looking at it, you know, you think that, you know, what's new? It looks like very much like embossing. People back in the 15th century or the 16th century, they used to use the same techniques to print coins. So what's new? I mean, it's the same technique. The only thing is that it works even better if you take it to a nano scale. So why is that? So it works even better at a nano scale because you have these capillary forces which assist in this nano imprint lithography. So say you have a big feature, you have a micron size feature, you only get limited capillary action, which is pushing your resist into this template. When you have a small template and you have these features which are of the order of a few nanometers, you get an even higher capillary action. So remember, capillary action depends, it's inversely proportional on the size of the feature. So it's a beautiful technique. It works even better at smaller features. Of course, there's no free lunch in the semiconductor industry. So how does this nano imprint lithography stack up in these different parameters that we use to judge any lithography solution. So on the on if you look at the scorecard, it's actually very good for resolution. It can essentially whatever resolution you can achieve on the template, you can exactly achieve it on your resist. In terms of CD uniformity, line width, roughness, again, best in the class. But the main problem, the main killer for nano imprint lithography is defects. So whenever there's a defect in the template, and it's very easy that you might get one or two defects in the template, it essentially balloons up and it creates more and more defects. First of all, it creates defect, the same defect in every wafer, and then it it balloons up and creates more and more defects. So that's one of the main challenges with this nano imprint lithography.